I'll tell you, when you deal with Excel, you go to help somebody, you don't know what you are gonna find. I went to a place to help these people, and there was hollering and cussing, and I heard somebody shout, "He slapped me!" And the guy said, "I'll slap you again." And I said, "Wait a minute, hold on. I gathered everybody together to see what they needed. What was gonna make all this madness stop? They needed this form. And they assured me that there would never, ever be 10 rows of data for the way things work. Okay, so we've got this form pre-made here. And an issue is somebody puts in one broom. Okay, we've got 17. But now somebody wants 30 brooms. There's nothing to say we don't have that many brooms. So that's one thing. But look at the form and see if you can spot another challenge with getting these numbers right. The problem we have can be seen with the clocks. Right now, there are two clocks being requested, and there are three in the inventory. And then down in row six, we can ask for two more clocks. So it is not good enough to have each row go and check a row in the inventory. We have to do something more. And then we need a way to prevent these entries or flag these entries. I've got this available column, and this is what we're going to do. Go up here, equals SUMIFS, open parentheses, sum what range? Sum this range, comma, what is the criteria range? This column, comma, what is the criteria? It's right here. Enter. We've got 17 brooms. That is true. Now I'm going to drag this down. Now, in the second row, got to go minus sum ifs, open parentheses. What is the sum range? I need D3 to D3. D3 to D3. Because I'm going to drag this down. I'm getting this formula prepared. And the first D3 does need absolute cell reference. Go to that one. F4, comma, what's the criteria range? It's going to be C3 to C3. C3, F4 to C3, comma, and what's the criteria? The criteria is right here. Clocks. Close the sum ifs. Enter. Now let's drag this down. Now we do see we started with three clocks available. And when we get down to row six, we've got one clock available and should not be able to enter a two or flag that two. That's the next thing we're going to do. Highlight this count. Go to conditional formatting. Highlight cell rules. Greater than what is in G3. But we got to get rid of those dollar signs because we want the conditional formatting to apply across that whole column. Got to get rid of that. Highlight, get rid of that. And you see that red has popped up, letting us know that 2 is against the law. Okay. Now notice those green errors. These are not errors, so I'm going to ignore those. Now, let's play with this. One clock is available. I've asked for 2. I'm going to put 1. Now, if I go down here and put clocks again, and then I put 1, see, it says 0 are available. But if I put in something else, brooms, see, it's telling me 17 brooms and I want 1, which is fine. It's okay and obvious to check a count against what's in the inventory. But we also have to check previous rows. And that's what was causing all that craziness. That's why that fella got slapped by the other fella. And when I left, there was joy and jubilation. See you in the next video.